Hello, I'm Nicholas Martin, resident theatre organist at Turner's. Behind this unassuming facade lies a treasure trove of bygone eras. So join me now as I show you around and play some of my favourite tunes on the Wurlitzer Theatre organ. Turner's opened in 1983 and houses a collection of organs and fairground memorabilia. It even has a classic car collection and some jukeboxes. Let's see what's on this one. Thank you. The gallopers at Turner's are over 100 years old and still the supreme ride of the fairground. This particular ride was built in 1896 by savages of King's Lynn in Norfolk. It features cockerels, horses and chariots. Originally it was a 4-abreast ride, but it was converted in the 50s to 3. This Wurlitzer is a three-manual 19-rank organ incorporating over 1,300 pipes built into the two chambers. On the console here we have almost 200 stop keys which provide me with all the tone colours and sounds that I need during my performance. Something very unique to this organ as well are the blue coloured stops, which are the piano. Piano sound is actually provided by two Yamaha MIDI expanders which hide behind the music desk here. Originally we had a Steck player grand piano connected to the organ, but with the passage of time we needed a little more room on the stage and this was removed in the mid-80s. Thank you. This organ is also fairly unique in the fact that it has 15 pistons or presets per keyboard. This allows me great flexibility in setting up all manner of sounds. It's also very modern, this organ, in the fact that it has solid-state technology throughout it. All of the old wiring from the 30s was ripped out in about 1987. Some of the percussion stops available on the organ are the xylophone over here. We have sleigh bells. Cathedral chimes, no less. Over on the other side of the organ, we have things like a tambourine. And chattering teeth, or Chinese block. Behind me is a mechanical jazz organ built by the Decap brothers of Antwerp in Belgium. This was a company founded in 1902, and in the main they built mechanical pipe organs for installation in dance halls and cafes. We're around the back of the Decap jazz organ now, and this is the old Hammond organ. These are the player books that work through the card frame over here. Shall we see how it sounds? This organ behind me is far more modern, having been built in the 1980s. It runs on a computerised system, and in fact the tunes are played via digital audio tape. Thank you. few years ago, Nigel Turner acquired a vast collection of memorabilia pertaining to Reginald Dixon. Here on my lap we have an album of photographs which go completely through Reggie's life. And here we have Mr. Blackpool, the Reginald Dixon book that was written by Peter Ashman. And here a collection of all Reggie's, well not all of them, but many of Reggie's albums that he did. Nigel's got almost the entire collection, I think, of LPs. But as we know, Reggie was one of the most prolific recording artists, organists that ever existed. Over here we have a picture of Reg sat at the our organ when it was in its previous home at Dis in Norfolk. Every October at Turner's, I perform a tribute concert to the memory of Reg Dixon. Join me now as I play a short tribute to him. Thank you. This Wurlitzer at Turner's was shipped over here in 1931 and opened at the Paramount, later Odeon Cinema in Newcastle upon Tyne. It was the sister Wurlitzer organ to the Paramount in Leeds, containing exactly the same specification and console design. It remained in the cinema until 1964, when it was sold to private buyers and put into storage. Sometime later, it was acquired for reinstallation into a car garage showroom, of all places, in Diss in Norfolk. Finally, in 1982, Nigel Turner purchased it to act as one of the central attractions here at Turner's in Northampton. When the renowned American theatre organist Jesse Crawford played the instrument, he stated that he thought it to be the best Wurlitzer installed in the country. This Jerome Kern medley starts with what is known as open harmony. Thank you. I hope you've enjoyed the special selection of music I've chosen for this video and the insight into the world of Turners. Don't forget to come and see us sometime. Let's have two old-time Walsh favourites. The first, Don't Be Cross by Carl Zeller, and the second, Destiny by Sidney Baines. Leroy Anderson had many hits in the 1950s with his mini classics. This is one of his most successful, The Blue Tango. Mm-hmm. This next piece has leanings towards Reginald Dixon. It's a high-tempo version of the Continental.